Why is it so difficult for some people to mind their own business? Why is it that some people are just difficult in life? They are just hard to get along with. I'm gonna share something with you, and I guess I'm not really mad, okay? I'm not really angry. I just wanted to share with you because it's been on my heart. I want to make two points. The first point that I want to make is you are a motivational speaker as well. And the other point is about the player haters, people who can make life difficult for you or for me. 4 years ago, maybe 5 years ago, I was in Haiti. I did an interview on television. After the interview, basically I was sharing my story. After the interview, a young lady came to the station. She got on her bicycle and she rushed to the television station. And she said to me, I was stepping out. She said to me, "Mr. Godfrey, I have to talk to you for a minute." She said, "I had to come here to give you a standing ovation." And she started clapping. That's all good. But she said to me, "Mr. Godfrey, 2 years ago, my very best friend, we were very close. She finished high school. She couldn't go to the university. She was so poor. She got to a point where she couldn't even buy shoes or clothes. And life was so difficult and miserable for her. She just couldn't take it any longer. She took a piece of rope. She went to a tree and she hung herself. But what she told me that was even more remarkable, she said, 2 years ago, had you come here, my best friend would be alive. She would not commit suicide." She said, "Mr. Godfrey, do you know why I say this to you?" I said, "No, tell me." She said, "It is because I was exactly where my friend was, mentally and emotionally. I felt like I just couldn't take it any longer. I was about to do what my friend did." She said, "Mr. Godfrey, thank you for giving me my life back. It's so meaningful to me." So basically the first point I want to make is you are a motivational speaker. Your story is not for you. Your journey, the thing that you've been through, it's not for you. It is for you to use as something therapeutic for others. People are going through things in life and they think they are the only one going through what they are going through and they want to give up. But when you share with them what you've been through and how you were able to pull yourself out of it, you are indeed a motivational speaker. I know many of you are already doing that. Look, I came to the United States. I read so many autobiographies, and from Abraham Lincoln to Benjamin Franklin, a lot of autobiographies, and all those people, they share their stories. Abraham Lincoln talked about his hardship when he was young. People like Oprah Winfrey talking about her life. We have celebrities in Hollywood. They used to be homeless. I know a guy who's big time here. He basically used to dump in the garbage cans behind the grocery store at night to find food. And they share their stories, though. They used to be homeless and all kinds of stories. But for many, it's really hard to share their story. And I want to talk about the player haters now. Well, I don't really think they are player haters, but I can't think of another name, a nicer name to give them now. Many of you are watching me, and I'm not talking about you, and you know who I'm talking about. You know you. You've been talking about me behind my back. You've been gossiping about me, telling people that my story is not true, and you knew me. By the way, there's a young lady who actually, I was doing an interview in Miami. After the interview, she called the radio station, the host, to tell the host that my story is not true. That young lady is from my village. I had never met her. She had never met me in person. And I found out that actually she was born in the village, but as a little kid, she left the village and never came back. There are people whom I would never imagine would stand in opposition. And some of them, you know, those people, they are very nice in front of your face. They and talk good talk, and but behind your back, they are talking about you. They are gossiping about you. And I know them because, you know, the words get around. You know, people will tell you. That's just the way it is. When a rattlesnake spread is venom, it's poison, you're going to know about it. Other people will tell you about it. The point that I'm trying to make here, by the way, I know that young lady now, I know her name, but I would never, never mention her name so that anybody doesn't know who I'm talking about. That's just me. I am not a rattlesnake. I'm not looking for everything that is bitter out of life and suck the bitterness and create a poison to destroy a man, to destroy a woman, to destroy a family. That's just not me. The reality is, when I first started sharing my story, here's the point I want to make here. Everybody knows me at a different chapter in my life. Like when I was in the village, my mother didn't know because she was not in the village. She left me behind. I stayed with a lady named Betila. So I had to really tell my mother what I went through. She didn't know. There are some people who met me when I was 15 years old, 16 years old. Some met me in Miami when I was like 22 or 23 years old. People know you at different stages. If you don't share the background, the backstory with them, they don't know much about you except for what they know now in the moment. And that's why so many people think they are the authority on my life, that they know my life better than me. When I share how I took a risk from Montreal, Canada to enter the United States, they were not there. They don't know. Even the people I left in Montreal didn't know the risk or the magnitude of the risk that I took to enter the United States of America. Now, if you are one of the haters, or maybe you are not a hater, you know what that is really? I believe that is what is called shadow repression. Shadow repression is when people are pushing something deep down in the shadow, so they don't want it to surface. They don't want to know about it. They don't want to be reminded of it. And here I am sharing my story, reminding them of what life was in Haiti. Look, there's no shame in the game. In fact, I don't even share the entire story because it's not really important. It's not really relevant. I think what I share is enough for people to experience a transformation. I can speak without sharing my story. I can speak on leadership. I can speak on influence and persuasion. I can speak on team building or teamwork. I can speak on customer service. I can speak on a lot of topics. I have a lot in my repertoire. But why do I choose to share my story? It's because I can speak on other topics and motivate people, but motivation is not enough for me. I go for transformation because transformation is more important than information. You can give somebody all the information in the world, and even if they are motivated, if they are not transformed, remember, be ye transformed, a renewing of the mind. And through stories, that's how you can do so. My sister was Marie, or Andrelle, that's what we call her. She actually, when I got to Port-au-Prince from the village, she was the first person who held my hand because I didn't know her. I didn't know my brother. I didn't know my sister. And I remember I saw so many cars, so many automobiles, and I was running across the street, and I thought it was like my village because we don't have that many cars. I thought I was still in the village, and I just ran across the street, and my sister, she ran after me and she grabbed me. She said, "What are you doing? You're gonna kill yourself. This is Port-au-Prince. There's a lot of cars." Port-au-Prince is a city where they have a lot of wealthy, rich people. By the way, when I share my story, I'm not sharing your story. I'm sharing my Haiti, the Haiti I knew when I was a kid. So we had very wealthy families in Haiti. They would drive Rolls Royce and Mercedes-Benz and Porsche, and they would I was told they would have dinner in Haiti on a weekend and then fly to Miami just to go party and have a good time and have a drink. That was not me. That was not my life. So are you telling me if I can share my story and cause somebody not to commit suicide? And I get letters from people, not just Haiti, in Africa, all over the world. Like, I remember this young lady who is a doctor now. When I started some 18, 20 years ago, she just didn't really know if she could pull that through. And because of my story, she is now a doctor. Are you telling me it's not worth it? Are you telling me I should listen to you who is somewhat mad? I'm sharing my story and then abandon those who are really struggling in life, who need the hope, who need the motivation? I'm sorry, my friend. I'm not going to please you. I'm going to continue to share my story. And by the way, I love you regardless. And I will never talk bad about you. I will never mention your name. In fact, I'm talking about you. And you know who you are, because a lot of time you watch my videos, you probably don't interact with what I'm doing. But I know, but I'll never talk about you. Don't worry. I'm not a rattlesnake. I choose to focus on the sweetness out of life, the good thing. That's just me. And I made a conscious decision to do that, all right? Take care and have a good one. I'm not really mad. I just wanted to share this. Now, I wonder, are you going to share this video with your friends or family or coworkers or, I mean, anybody that might want to hear this? Just share it, all right? Take care. Have a good one.